Welcome to the Help for Leaders podcast. I'm Stacey Harris, and I'm passionate about showing leaders the power of communication and how it can transform their organizations, from Fortune 500 boardrooms all the way to brand new startups. As a leader, your actions and your words transform people and your company culture. So join me as I share tips and insights for elevating your leadership abilities as well as your team's performance. Let's dive right in. Hey everyone, welcome back. I'm Stacey Harris. You're joining me in my living room, so I hope you get comfortable. Today we're going to talk about emotions, and we're going to dive deeper into emotional intelligence. So I want to talk to you from a standpoint of leadership and how we lead and how emotions impact our leadership styles. So if you just think about how powerful emotions are, we've experienced emotions from excitement to sadness to anger to frustration. And as a leader, we realize that our emotions are contagious, but so is leadership. And I really want to help you understand the ability to lead from a place of understanding EQ. Do you know effective leaders, people who are actually really high in EQ, understand the links between emotions and how it impacts behavior? People with high EQ are actually more productive. People with high levels of EQ actually collaborate more on the job. And I think it's so impactful to our leadership that it's worth having a conversation about today. So let's talk about people with low EQ, okay? So when you have low EQ, you often feel misunderstood. You often feel like people just don't get me. Individuals with low EQ actually get upset easily. They have very short fuse. They can get upset. They can get frustrated. They let it impact their own ability to lead. So low EQ also, we can become overwhelmed with our emotions when we have low EQ. Those emotions feel overwhelming. They feel like they're in control of us rather than us being in control of our emotions. Individuals also with low EQ have problems being assertive. They have problems standing up and speaking up when necessary. So I really want to talk about emotions and how they impact our leadership from that standpoint of high EQ or low EQ. And the great thing about EQ, it's unlike IQ. I know we've all heard about IQ, that intellectual quotient. EQ is actually emotional quotient. It's the measure of emotional intelligence. And we can absolutely increase our EQ. Where your IQ is pretty set from early age, we can actually learn through practice, through skill building, how to increase our EQ at any stage of our career, any stage of our life. We can also intentionally decrease our EQ. So as leaders, I really hope that you'll tap into increasing your EQ, really tap into understanding emotions and how they impact you as a leader, because we do want to really maintain and enhance our interpersonal relationships and our communication and be able to grow as a leader. As we lead teams, we want to understand how our emotions impact our team. So I really want to give you some specifics and some strategies on how to increase EQ so that you have a better understanding. You know, EQ, higher levels of EQ, we actually can manage stress more effectively. And how many of us as leaders feel stress on a daily basis? I do. Stress is, it's normal. It's a normal part of life. And even in this day and age, stress is actually increased. And if we can't effectively manage our emotions and understand how to channel that stress into a positive, productive way, it can actually be a detriment to us as individuals, as we lead, and it can be a detriment to our teams. So we really want to engage in effectively increasing our EQ. If you haven't listened to the episode that I talked about all the specific aspects of EQ, I encourage you to go find that episode and listen. I go into detail about all five aspects of self-awareness, self-regulation, motivation, social awareness, and social regulation, and I give tips for each one on how to grow in emotional intelligence. And so again, it impacts our communication. It's so specific, and we can do really small things to grow and increase our EQ. I mean, there's great books that you can read. I think every airport, when I used to travel pre-COVID, when we could travel, you'd walk through a bookstore in an airport and probably at least two to three of the books on the bookshelf had to do with emotional intelligence. Read about it, learn about it, learn about your own style, and figure out how you can grow, whether it's being really simple things from listening to music to going for walks to decreasing stress in physical ways, or maybe it's rest. Maybe you need to, you know, read a book, get in nature, do things like that that actually will help you decrease your stress levels so that you can understand those emotions and how they impact others. I share some real practical tips in that previous episode of listening to music, going for walks, riding bikes, reading books, all of those things for self-regulation, but awareness is key as well. I've got to understand my emotions. I've got to understand how they impact me. I've got to understand even physiologically what's going on, because EQ is actually a precognitive response. Those emotions happen before we even actually have a rational thought. Something is triggering us. Something is either exciting us, it's causing anger, stress, frustration. And there's this tiny little piece of our brain called the amygdala that can actually take over and hijack our emotions. We like to use that term of an emotional hijack. I think we all understand what's happening when the emotions are just spiraling us out of control and we don't have that ability to regulate. But if we can learn to pause, 6 seconds is all it takes. I know sometimes that feels like a very long, awkward silence. But if we can learn to just pause, even take deep breaths to help calm our central nervous system, it'll help us re-engage the logic part of our brain, that prefrontal cortex, so that we can think, so that we're not being hijacked emotionally. You know, we were wired to have that fight, flight, freeze aspect. It's actually for protection, but what can happen is if it's overused and we don't understand how to get back into that logic piece of our brain, we're leading from emotions. And emotions are great indicators that something's going on. It's data. We need to realize that it's information that's telling us something. But if we lead from that place of emotions, it's not effective. Use it as data to tell us what we're experiencing, but pause. Let our bodies kind of regulate those chemicals that are flowing through so that then we can re-engage the logic piece and speak from that as we lead others. It's so key. So learning that 6 second pause, learning how to take some deep breaths. Maybe it's listening to music. Maybe it's going for a walk. Maybe it's having a conversation with a mentor or someone that you trust. That can be really effective in helping you understand how emotions are impacting how you lead. Well, thank you for joining me in my living room. I hope you've learned something that you can apply as you lead others. Join us on our next episode as we share more practical tips, more information on communication. You can follow us on social media, on Instagram, on YouTube. Thank you for being here in my living room. Thank you for joining us today. You have the potential to communicate, engage, and lead with significant impact, and my goal is to help you do just that. Whether you're trying to get that next big promotion, scale your small business, or manage a team of thousands, there's always room for growth, and I can help you get there. Go to disc-report.com and find out what style of leader you are by downloading my free ebook on communication. Until next time, lead well and prosper.